To say that conditions are chaotic in the U.S. supply chains is quite an understatement. Americans are seeing shelves getting increasingly emptier at stores all over the country. Shortages and soaring prices have become the new normal. And a series of new issues keep aggravating the supply chain crisis ahead of the winter. Months ago, the Vice President warned that U.S. consumers should start placing their holiday orders early this year if they wanted their products to arrive in time for the festivities. Since last year, the unprecedented spike in consumer demand, fueled by government stimulus checks and a huge pile of printed money, has created a massive imbalance in the markets as the volume of available supplies started to dwindle all across the globe. To make things worse, new measures that impose 24/7 operations at U.S. ports are making the backlog of cargo ships and containers even bigger. And vaccine mandates are making the worker shortage even more severe. The way the U.S. government has mishandled the supply chain crisis is truly catastrophic. They have managed to create even more disruptions in every step of the way. With the memory of depleted supplies during last year's panic buying frenzy, consumers got spooked by the warnings of shortages and placed an extraordinary amount of orders this year, which may have broken U.S. supply chains, according to industry experts. But the panic buying retailers have been doing has made the problem significantly worse. Thanksgiving and Black Friday are, of course, just around the corner. Both dates mark the beginning of the biggest shopping days of the year. Retailers usually expect to make up for the lost revenue and kick off a buying frenzy that hopefully lasts for months. This year, however, those hopes will be crushed. The congestion at ports is so severe that millions of holiday items will not arrive in time at the stores. Just like consumers, retailers have been panic buying for the holidays as the supply chain crisis raises fears of empty shelves during their most profitable season of the year. Although over-ordering might be a natural instinct, given the warnings of shortages, for retailers, that strategy actually backfired, according to supply chain experts. Dr. Tinglong Dai, a professor of operations management and business analytics at Johns Hopkins University, told Business Insider, "If people think the banks are gonna collapse, they go to the ATM and take out all their money, causing them to collapse. The same goes for supply chains," he explains. "When people expect there's going to be shortages for this holiday season, they increase their orders, which lead to a dramatic increase in shipping to the U.S. That's why we see so many containers in our ports." The professor highlighted that this is a self-fulfilling process that's being intensified by the bullwhip effect, a phenomenon that causes systemic failures across supply chains, such as prolonged wait times and blocks inventory at ports, all thanks to distorted demand. "It's the industrial equivalent of stores running out of toilet paper," described Ted Stank, faculty director of the Global Supply Chain Institute at the University of Tennessee. "When retailers start to panic and order more products earlier than they usually would, manufacturers understand this as a sign of rising consumer demand. Then they react by increasing their orders from suppliers, further inflating demand at a time the production of new supplies is limited." Consumer behavior was the beginning, Dai argues, but eventually it's the retailers and manufacturers whose actions have caused this supply chain crisis. Different from banks, which have regulations to prevent panic withdrawn scenarios, there are no restrictions to limit how many units can be ordered by retailers in a given time frame. But instead of ensuring inventory for the coming shopping season, the panic ordering has resulted in empty shelves as deliveries are delayed and many other bottlenecks at many steps along the way continue to keep products out of the reach of consumers. Prologis CEO Hamid Moghaddam says there isn't enough stuff in the pipe to feed all of the demand that's happening. "Every port is congested. Every container is in the wrong place," According to Moghaddam, the supply chain is too fragmented at this point and there isn't enough slack in the system. He added, a system that was really built for everything working right is now having to deal with a situation where nothing is working right. And it's gonna take a while before this can straighten itself out. When the supply chain operations will return to normal is anyone's guess, but in the meantime, the economy is paying the price. Experts like Tim Hoy of Moody's Analytics argue that, unfortunately, supply chain problems will get even worse before they get better. As the global economy continues to gather steam, what is increasingly apparent is how it will be stymied by supply chain disruptions that are now showing up at every corner, Hoy said in a recent report. Hoy cited problems as strict border controls and mobility restrictions, unavailability of a global vaccine pass, a ravaging energy crisis, and a historic shortage of dock workers as some of the main drivers to the global port crisis. Production all over the world continues to be hampered by factory shutdowns due to the shortage of power in major manufacturing countries such as China. Philip Richardson, an American CEO who runs a factory based in China, says random power outages plaguing the country are costing him time and money. Richardson revealed, if we're shut down for more than 15 minutes, it creates a headache. A generator keeps the factory running, but noted that electricity from a generator for our application costs me at least four times more per hour. The fact that port congestion is just as bad on the other side of the planet isn't helping the situation at all. The labor shortage at Chinese ports is even more serious, as all dock workers have to spend 3 weeks in isolation for every 2 weeks on the job. It currently takes almost an entire month to ship a container from China to the US West Coast, and when cargo ships arrive with thousands of containers, they're having to wait off the coast of Southern California for up to 4 weeks before getting unloaded. Once the ships are finally unloaded, thousands of containers are then stacked as far as the eye can see, having to wait additional weeks before trucks and trains arrive to carry them across the United States. Supply will likely play catch-up for some time, particularly as there are bottlenecks in every link of the supply chain. Labor, certainly, but also containers, shipping, ports, trucks, railroads, air, and warehouses, Hoy outlined, adding that delivery delays are leading to local shortages, which are driving consumer prices higher, while freight costs jump to decade highs. The cheapest freight rate to carry merchandise coming from China to the United States is now in the range of $25,000. That is a 200% increase from 2019 levels. But many big companies are paying premiums at the spot market that can go as high as $100,000. That is leading to a painful price spike once those products hit store shelves. The problem is getting so alarming that even the White House is admitting that further price increases are coming, even though policymakers repeatedly insisted that inflation would be a temporary event. It's clear now it's going to last for a long, long time. On Monday, White House officials told Reuters that Americans should brace for higher prices and sparser shelves this winter as port congestion intensifies. In Vesco's Chief Global Marketing Strategist, Christina Hooper, exposed in a report released last week that the U.S. economic growth is likely to be hard hit by this crisis as GDP collapses and inflation runs wild. A number of large American companies are already reporting a substantial drop in earnings as they have to pay higher prices for pretty much everything. Hooper wrote, no matter where companies are, they are likely experiencing supply chain disruptions, higher input costs, and issues sourcing labor. Some companies will be far more impacted than others, she continued. A rise in cost will generally have the greatest impact on low-margin companies, which tend to be found in sectors such as transportation, general retail, construction, and autos, Companies that should be least impacted are those with wide profit margins, limited raw material costs, and small workforces. That should include growth sectors such as tech and healthcare, she said. However, those sectors' stocks will suffer the most as bond yields rise. That is to say, even the industries least impacted by the supply chain crisis, which are now the backbone of the economy, are bound to face steep losses as central banks hike interest rates and burst the financial bubble supporting their growth. Needless to say, hundreds of thousands of small businesses may go down in that process, and even giants like Amazon and Apple are already losing billions due to the market imbalances brought by our politicians and our policymakers. Amazon announced that its entire fourth quarter profit might be wiped out by a surge in the cost of labor and fulfillment. Apple disclosed it lost $6 billion in sales because of its inability to meet demand and could even lose more in the next quarter. What a situation the United States has gotten into. Everywhere we look, we have disruption on top of disruption. And our leaders effectively made our problems a whole lot worse. If you think things are bad now, just wait until the Fed raises rates to try to control rampant inflation. The central bank will take out the air of equity bubbles it inflated throughout the past 18 months, and during that process, it will collapse markets and push the economy back into recession. At the beginning of the year, many of us were hoping that conditions would improve for the economy, but now we're stuck in one of history's biggest traffic jams. This crisis has become so serious that analysts at Bloomberg Economics are calling it the Big Crunch of 2021. In a new indicator developed to evaluate the extremity of the problem, the analysts found that supply shortages are now at a 20-year high in the U.S. What comes next is uncharted territory because bottlenecks are feeding on each other. The international flow of goods has never been so clogged, and the timing couldn't be worse for an economy exiting the deepest recession of modern times. With prices hitting new records with each passing week, it's only a matter of time until we face a rerun of 1970s-style hyperinflation. That's why saying the situation is chaotic at U.S. supply chains is an understatement. This is a gigantic mess that will take years to solve. And Americans will be lucky if the markets, the economy, and supply chains don't break down simultaneously before the end of 2021. A lot more trouble is ahead as this perfect storm evolves into a full-blown disaster in the coming months.